Welcome to another video in this mini series of taking control of inner crises. So I hope you've been finding them useful so far. It's certainly been good for me to get out and spread the word about actually how people do things in their head, because really the way that we respond to crises is about our habits, our patterns, our behaviours. And if we can just change those habits, patterns, behaviours by understanding things, by therefore changing things, and then we can take control, then that's got to help us throughout the whole of our life, hasn't it? And that's what I'm really passionate about. So I'm grateful to be able to do these for you. One of the first things that I spoke to someone about was that they had an inability to focus. So it was sort of almost like there was a whole load of stuff going on in their head. They didn't know which way to turn, what to look for first, what to hear, what to feel. And it was just a bit, you know, disabling. I call myself an unsticker. And one of the big things about getting stuck is that you're not focused and you haven't really got the plans. And I was thinking that the reality is that your conscious mind sets your goals, but your unconscious mind, that's running your body, storing all your memories, responsible for your emotions and your behaviour, is the thing that actually gets your goals. And if you can't focus, and we talked a lot about our reality, the picture that we got in our head, if that's actually crammed full of sort of irrelevant stuff, things that your unconscious mind's given you because it's protecting you. Perhaps you better watch this television, perhaps you better talk to this person, perhaps you better just sit there and do nothing. That's all actually crammed in your head, along with all the things that you may think that you ought to be doing, that you could be doing, that, you know, so that when all this is over, that you'll be fully sort of up and running with a focused mind. So I think it's really important to be able to focus, and sometimes when we're not focused, it almost feels like there's a bit of a battle going on in your head, and it's not particularly helpful, because if you remember, the battles in our head create our emotional state, have an effect on our cells, create a behavior. So if you've got a battle going on in your head, it's not particularly useful. So one of the things that I've learned over the years is to do a bit of a brain dump. Now, a brain dump is just taking a piece of paper, several bits of paper probably in this time, and just writing down everything that's in your head that you think that you've got to do. That doesn't need to be in any order, it doesn't need to be short, it doesn't need to be long, it is what it is. And the reality is that if you clear this out so that you are then able to focus on plans, on taking action, on keeping yourself really safe by being positive and emotionally resilient, then that's got to be a good thing, hasn't it? So just get a book, piece of paper, and just do a brain dump. I mean, the first time I did one, I think I had about 7 pages worth, and I then categorised them into things that I had to do, things that were important, things that were less important, things that I could delegate. And before I knew where I was down to about a page. And by the time I'd done 2 or 3 days of work, actually that list was more or less gone, and I just started to do another brain dump. So I think if you can't focus, then do a brain dump and just accept that if you're feeling fuzzy, I mean, I'm feeling a bit fuzzy at the moment, brain's a little bit like jelly, but it, you know, there's also a lot of stuff that I've written down on pieces of paper, particularly to talk to you about, that has helped me, and that's created quite a calm emotional state, a positive state, and I've got a plan and I've got some actions to do, and therefore I'm focused. It's an interesting time, because we seem to have a lot more time to do all this stuff at the moment, isn't it? And I think that's the advantage as well of creating routines and patterns of behaviour during the day, so that also enables you to focus, take control, and get rid of all the sort of not particularly pleasant stuff that's sitting in your reality that's stopping you from doing things. So I hope you're enjoying the videos. It's fascinating how our brain works. it's fascinating how this process works. It's really useful to completely understand it. If you want some help, advice, give me a shout. If you want me to explain it more, give me a shout. And yeah, I shall talk to you tomorrow.